Alright, so more bottles of champagne are popped during the holiday season than at any other time of the year. French law states that grapes from the region of Champagne must be used for a bottle of sparkling wine to be called champagne. But from a chemical perspective, champagne obeys another law, Henry's law. This law states that the pressure of a gas above a solution is proportional to the concentration of the gas in the solution. Carbon dioxide gas is at the heart of champagne's famous bubbly character. In an unopened bottle of champagne, the carbon dioxide dissolved in the wine is in balance, or equilibrium, with gas in the space between the cork and the liquid. Uncorking releases the gas and throws off the equilibrium. Also, according to Henry's law, the dissolved carbon dioxide leaves the champagne via bubbles, which re-establishes the equilibrium. Champagne makes its gas naturally during fermentation. During this process, yeast gobble up sugar molecules called glucose and fructose in grape juice, converting them into carbon dioxide and ethanol, the type of alcohol found in alcoholic beverages. Unlike other wines, champagne undergoes a second fermentation in the bottle to trap carbon dioxide gas, which dissolves into the wine and forms bubbles. Legend tells us that a French monk named Dom-Pierre Perignon discovered champagne in the mid-1600s. In Perignon's era, winemakers had a tough time with that second fermentation. Some bottles wound up with no bubbles at all, while others got too much carbon dioxide and exploded under the enormous pressure. And, well, no one wants that. More than 600 different chemical compounds join carbon dioxide in champagne, each lending its own unique quality to the aroma and flavor of a glass of bubbly. But even with all that flavor, champagne would just be another white wine without those tiny bubbles. As the bubbles ascend the length of a glass in tiny trails, they drag along molecules of flavor and aroma which explode out of the surface, tickling the nose and stimulating the senses. The bubbly surface of champagne is also a feast for the eyes, especially under a microscope. When an exploding bubble deforms its neighbors, gorgeous flower-shaped structures blossom and disappear in the blink of an eye. So, what's the best way to pour a glass of bubbly and maximize the sensory experience? A study published in the American Chemical Society's Journal of Agricultural and Food Chemistry answered that question. Pouring champagne on an angle preserves up to twice the carbon dioxide bubbles when compared to pouring down the middle of the glass. So pop some bottles of bubbly and enjoy what's left of this year. As you're drinking, be sure to check out some of our other videos such as How Breathalyzers Work or Sexy Time Chemistry. While you're at it, bring in the new year with hitting that subscribe button. Happy holidays from us here at Reactions.